frame. The Ohio State youth movement is embodied by freshman sensation Jimmy Jackson. Ohio's player of the year has lived up to his billing. Norm Stewart has guided Missouri to number 7 in the country. Leading scorer Doug Smith is serious about keeping the momentum on Mizzou's side while he takes his Tigers into the paint. However, Larry Finch's Memphis State Tigers are by no means a pushover. Leading scorer Elliott Perry likes to take the long route to the hoop. Following SportsCenter, last year's Pac-10 Freshman of the Year, Don McClain, hopes to pick up where he left off, as the Bruins hope their powerful front court can make their point. But the Bulldogs love to let it fly at Cellon Arena, with super sophomore Wilbert Hooker leading the way. The Bulldogs hope to claw their way past the Bruins. A triple header next.
The city of New Orleans is pumped up, and why not? It's Sugar Bowl week down here in the Crescent City, where Miami and Alabama will tee it up on Monday. So what do they do to celebrate while they wait? They play basketball. Any excuse for a party in New Orleans. Tonight, it's LaSalle and Ohio State in the first game of the Sugar Bowl Classic. Hello, everybody. I'm Barry Tompkins, along with Dan Bonner. And Dan, tonight, no question, we're going to see one of the premier players in the country. He plays for LaSalle. Name is Lionel Simmons, and he might be struggling just a little bit right now.
He might be struggling a little bit, Barry. Anytime that a player is shooting 40% from the field, you have to say, well, maybe he's struggling. But he's one of the country's premier players. Coming back from last year where he finished number 3 in the country in scoring, number 5 in rebounding, truly one of the country's outstanding basketball players. At 6'7", he actually plays a power forward for LaSalle. Very good moves around the basket. He's got three-point range. He runs very well. Those are his stats. A lot of guys would like to struggle like that. He's still an outstanding player.
No question about it. Tonight against Ohio State as the opponents. This is a team that is on a three-game winning streak. Randy Ayers, first-year coach, and he rather had the cupboard left bare for him by Gary Williams, who went off to Maryland.
Well, Randy Ayers has some inexperienced people and is, in fact, as an inexperienced coach himself, but just like his players, he's a very talented young coach. He's led by the most highly touted freshman in Ohio last year, a young man by the name of Jimmy Jackson. You can see what he's done for the Buckeyes so far this year. Leads them in rebounding and assists, has been in double figures every game, so he certainly lived up to expectations. Randy Ayers, I think, sees really a good future for this team.
And they have won 3 games in a row, all at home. Now they have to take the act on the road, and they have to beat an unbeaten team in the process. LaSalle has won 5 and lost none, and they are playing very well, despite the fact that Lionel Simmons is only averaging 40% from the floor. When we come back, we'll get started. Right now, back to Bristol and John Saunders.
Okay, thanks a lot, Perry and Dan. We'll get you back to New Orleans in just a moment. LaSalle, number 20 against Ohio State. The first of 3 games we'll have for you here tonight. Our second game will be Missouri, ranked number 7 in the nation, against Memphis State, number 15, a battle of Tigers. Then we'll step aside for SportsCenter, come back at midnight Eastern Time, number 16 UCLA against Fresno State. At halftime, we will have top 25 scores, and we'll also hear from Bill Curry, the coach of Alabama, as he prepares his Crimson Tide for the Sugar Bowl. So stay with us. Quite a night of basketball ahead. LaSalle and Ohio State next.
There's never been an offer like this before.